Hey, what's going on, guys? Jolts here, back with another item guide, and today we're going over the legendary Dictator. This gun is ridiculous. It'll shred almost everything. To get it, you want to farm Agonizer over at the Guts of Carnivora. Now, it can also drop from Terror during the main story, but he is normally only a one-time kill. So yeah, let's head over and get the gun. Alright, so what you want to do is head over to Pandora at the Guts of Carnivora and head all the way to the end. And we're going to take on Agonizer 9000. So yeah, let's head over. On your way over, you will hit the save right here so that when you save quit, you're going to spawn right here making a short walk to the boss. Alright, let's do it. Okay, get terrified, jump in a suit, hop on out. That's going to activate something for the road, give me infinite ammo. We're going to do a lot of torch stickies and blow them up. There we go. Go up to the core. And boss down. Alright, did we get it first run? Probably not. Oh. Alright, well, we got a first run. That doesn't always happen. But anyways, we have the Dictator. Damage, good. Accuracy handling, it's okay. Reload time, fair. Fire rate, pretty fast. And mag size, 40. Red text is, let them hate me so that they will but fear me. This one is anointed, but we're not going to worry about that for the testing. Also, this gun can come in all the elements. Alright, the gun looks pretty good. It's gold with a touch of gray, and it has vault symbols engraved on the side of it. Looks pretty good. This gun is pretty cool, so when you shoot it, it's going to be 3 bullets, and if you ADS, it's going to get a lot more accurate. The accuracy is kind of the problem with the gun, so it's going to be meant for close range. But when you go into bipod mode, you're getting 7 bullets per shot. And what's also cool is you can find it times 6, so you can have 6 bullets per shot. And when you go into bipod mode, it's going to be 14 bullets per shot. But it will consume 2 ammo per shot for the times 6 variant. When you're not in bipod mode, you can run freely, but when you go into bipod mode, you walk really slow. And also, you cannot jump. Alright, so we're on Mayhem 4, any modifiers are neutral. Push forward. So non-bipod mode. Let's go ahead and go for this guy. And the damage is not too bad. That's actually pretty good. And now if you go into bipod mode, that's going to be over double that damage. But you do walk slower. And also, be sure to aim down sight because it will be a lot more accurate if you do that. Okay, this guy right here. Let's get behind him. Go for the crit. And he's dead. This gun has crazy damage. And if you land all 7 pellets on a crit, almost everything in the game will melt. Now, while the debuff for the bipod movement is kind of annoying, you definitely want to use it all the time for extra damage. I mean, I guess you could go into non-bipod mode, get to the enemy, and go bipod, but I feel like it's better to actually swap your weapon, get to the enemy, and then swap back over. Do you guys remember the Hydra from Borderlands 1 and 2? This is basically a full auto version of that gun. And boss down. Easy peasy, dude. Alright, so final thoughts on the Dictator. It is very strong. It has good damage, good fire rate, consumes 1 ammo per shot for 7 pellets. This thing is ridiculous. It shreds mobs on Mayhem 4 and also bosses. It is honestly the ultimate gun. Now, the only downside is it will make you slow when you're in bipod mode, and also you cannot jump when you're using bipod. But that is a perfectly fair trade-off to me. Overall, I would recommend the gun, and no matter what build you're running, go ahead and try this out. No joke, it works on almost every build. So yeah, go ahead and pick it up and try it for yourself, guys. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and of course, if you did, then please be sure to leave a like, because that'd be awesome. And if you guys really enjoyed it, be sure to sub. You guys have a great day, and I will see you all later. Peace out.